Welcome to La Trenza with Lupe and Zia. This is about day four or so of our stay-at-home quarantine. And so I've been trying to keep up with my students from Roybal Learning Center and also trying to get Mateo and Zia busy with a schedule, trying to keep life as normal as possible. And so what I have found is that there are some folks out there that would like to have culturally relevant lessons. And if you didn't know that this was gonna happen and you didn't get out to the public library like we did, or you know, we pretty much have our own culturally relevant ethnic studies-based library here as well, you might be stuck without books. So we decided that we're gonna read a book to you today from a book that we checked out at the Benjamin Franklin Library in Boyle Heights just last week. Actually, you may have seen some of our pictures that we posted online on our Instagram. Okay, we're gonna go ahead and get started. Today, we're gonna read a book called Going Down Home with Daddy. Written by Callie Starling Lyons and illustrated by Daniel Minter. Going Down Home with Daddy. On reunion morning, we rise before the sun. Daddy hums as he packs our car with suitcases and a cooler full of snacks. He says there's nothing like going down home. We leave when the sky is still dark with sleep. Sis closes her eyes, but mine stay wide open. I watch as we drive from city streets to flowing highways under a sweep of sparkling stars. Lil Ellen, Mom says after a while, you better catch some Z's while you can. I try to rest but can't stop smiling. Soon I'll get to see my great grandma, Granny, and hang out with my cousins. But when I look at my hands, empty as the road in front of us, my grin fades. The anniversary celebration, I bet everyone will have something to share except me. I doze off in a cloud of worry and wake to see sunbeams tickling my face. I squint and see a familiar John Deere tractor store and a gray silo standing at attention. We're almost there. Sis and I sit up straight as pines when we see Granny's wood frame house. She's right where we left her after last year's reunion, scattering corn for her chickens like tiny bits of gold. There she is, Sis shouts. Granny spreads her arms wide and wraps us both inside. My, my, she says, and showers our cheeks with peppermint kisses. I missed you so. All afternoon, a parade of family comes home. Grandma Loretta and Grandpa James, aunts and uncles, and more cousins than I can count. Got a head just like your daddy, Uncle Jay teases me. Daddy's eyes twinkle. Now I know you're not talking about heads. Can't take them anywhere, Grandma Loretta says, laughing. While the grown-ups catch up, we cousins run to the fence to visit Granny's cows and goats. You doing something for the celebration? Isaiah asks Sis. Singing Granny's favorite song. His eye is on the sparrow, she says. How about you? Reading Mother to Son by Langston Hughes. I made a scrapbook in Granny's favorite color blue, Devin says. You got something, little lamb?
I kick a stone and my eyes start to burn. Ready for a tractor ride? She asks, saving me from having to answer. I swallow hard and climb into the trailer with Sis and Mama. I lean against the hay as Daddy drives us past the smokehouse and fishing pond and tumbles by a field dotted with puffs of white. That was actually rumbles by a field dotted with puffs of white. Cotton has been on this land a long time just like us, Daddy says. Pa would drive your Uncle Jay and me on a tractor just like this one. Look to your left, Pa would say. Look to your right. The land is meant to go on forever. Everything you see, Pa told us, is ours. I think about what Daddy said and sit up tall. Pa is gone, but this is our time to come together and remember. On Sunday, I feel sick. Not a fever and sneezing sick, but a I wish I had more time sick. The celebration starts at dusk. Get a move on, little Ann, Grandma Loretta says. You know, Granny doesn't play. Growing up, we never missed a service. At church, Daddy points to the spot where he and Uncle Jay performed a duet on trombone and trumpet. My hands were shaking so much I could barely play, Daddy says. But then I saw Granny smiling. My jitters went away. I wonder if looking at Granny will help me. But when our eyes meet, all I can think about is being the only kid with nothing to say. After service, we head back to Granny's and change into our reunion t-shirts. Generations of our family smile from every wall. Mama, Sis, and I peer at black and white pictures of Pa and Granny. Their eyes, brave and bold, remind me of Daddy's. You have their eyes too, Mama says. That's when it comes to me. I think about everything I see when I'm here. I think about the tractor ride and Daddy's stories. I think about walking in Pa's and Granny's footsteps, in those of our people and native people long before. I think and collect treasures from our land. I lift my head to the sun. Your fingers are covering some words. Just before satin night falls, we sit outside on porch steps and metal lawn chairs. It's celebration time. Our people were stolen from Africa and shipped to this continent in chains, Daddy says. But no one could lock away their dreams. They dreamt on this land during slavery. They dreamt on this land as they made a way out of no way and fought Jim Crow. 75 years ago, a farmer and a teacher bought this land. Daddy gazes at Granny. And look at us now. One after another, cousins offer their tributes. Sis's song makes Granny's eyes shine. Isaiah's poem gets everyone nodding. Then I step forward. I feel like a spotlight is blazing just on me. I look down and say nothing. It's okay, little Ellen, Sis whispers. I lift my head and see gleaming smiles. I try again. Cardona cotton for the quilts Granny made to keep her children warm, I say, holding a white cloud in my fingers. A pecan for the trees Pa planted and all of the kids love to climb. I pinch dirt and let it rain to the ground. And earth for the land that's ours as far as we can see. Fireflies wink and whirl in a carnival around us. That's all right, I hear Granny say. Daddy flashes a thumbs up. I grin up at the moon. It glows back at me. We're a mighty family, Daddy booms. Mighty! We roar back. Then we try to make the night stretch on forever. As grown-ups slap cards and checkers against tables, we cousins dig through old trunks and laugh until our heads explode with joy. Too soon, our goodbye morning comes. We hug all the way to the door. Then we climb into our car and watch Granny and her house shrink and disappear. When we go down home with Daddy, everything we see holds a piece of him and us. We head up the highway thinking about family and dreaming about next year. Let's take a look at the author. Her name is Kelly Starling Lyons. She is the author of numerous books for young readers, including One More Dino on the Floor, Hope's Gift, Alan's Broom, and the Jada Jones series. Going Down Home with Daddy was inspired by her husband's heritage and her own. Today, she's proud to share the reunion tradition with her children. She lives in North Carolina. You can go to www.callystarlinglyons.com for more info. Let's take a look at the illustrator. His name is Daniel Minter. He is a painter and illustrator whose work has been exhibited both nationally and internationally. He is the illustrator of 11 books for children, including Step Right Up, How Doc and Jim Kay Taught the World About Kindness, and Alan's Broom, also written by Kelly Starling Lyons, for which he received a Coretta Scott King Illustration Honor Award. He lives in Maine. For more info, you can go to www.danielminter.net. Thank you for reading. Remember, nothing is more important than family.
Thank you for reading.
This is a great book. So what I wanted to do was just to show you how you can do other activities to expand on the book. It took us about, I don't know, like 13 minutes to read it, something like that. But you can really turn this into a lesson that can expand way beyond those 13 minutes. And you can do it with all age groups. So I'm going to share with you some of the strategies that I use, both with my students and also with my own children, because I want to make sure that it goes beyond just like the entertainment value. I really want them to have some really important endured learning, especially with a book like this that is very beautiful and has some really good intentions. And so before I do that, what I want to do is I want to share one of the guiding principles of the Liberated Ethnic Studies Model Curriculum, number 2 specifically, and that is to celebrate and honor Native peoples of the land and communities of color by providing a space to share their stories of struggle and resistance along with their intellectual and cultural wealth. So you can hear in that guiding principle a lot of the scholarly work of Tara Yasso, of R. Tolteca Cuautin, of Alison Tintianco Cubales, and Edward Curameng. They have been instrumental in guiding the work of the Liberated Ethnic Studies Model Curriculum Coalition that formed just recently. So let's go ahead and look at some of the strategies that you can use with this book. So one of the first ones I want to share with you is a strategy called close reading. And so I do this a lot with my students where, you know, we may read a whole, like, you know, scene or an act of a play
And, you know, I have English language learners in my classrooms. I have, you know, students that, you know, they may have not that much of an attention span or whatever the case may be, right? But I want to make sure that of everything that we read, that there's certain things that they catch, right? And so one of the things that you can do a close read on with this book specifically is on this page here.
So let's do a close read just of this part of the story. You have their eyes too, Mama says. That's when it comes to me. I think about everything I see when I'm here. I think about the tractor ride and Daddy's stories. I think about walking in paws and Granny's footsteps and those of our people and native people long before. I think and collect treasures from our land. I lift my head to the sun.
So this is a great example of this author, Kelly Starling-Lyons, and Daniel Minter, the illustrator, connecting to the fact that the land that belongs to their family is also the land of Native people. So you can go and extend on this. You can, with your children at home, you can go to the website nativeland.ca. and actually put in the address of your home to be able to know like which native peoples that land belongs to, you know, the land that you're standing upon. But you can also look at like your family's migration stories and find out the, you know, where your family came from, the native peoples from that land. And then you can even research their traditions and see if any of those traditions have also become part of like your own family's traditions. So there's lots of really cool things you can do with the close read. There are many things in here you can close read on. You know, I really love like the connection with the great grandma. I love the connection of the little sis and how she really motivates little Alan. So there are lots of different areas in here that you can close read to bring out some of the themes that you feel connected to and that you want your kids to feel connected to. For me, I really appreciated that because it's a very good like solidarity statement in the book. You know, the book is about African American folks and African American traditions, specifically like the author's family. But in there, they really honor the Native peoples as well, which goes with that guiding principle, right? Celebrate and honor Native peoples of the land and communities of color by providing a space to share their stories of struggle. And so I wanted to share that. So something else that you can do is something that I did. You may have noticed that in the video, there's music, right? And so the long song at the beginning is actually a Miles Davis song. And that was inspired by the fact that, you know, Miles Davis is somebody that my husband has researched a lot about, knows a lot about, and we know that he's one of a very talented individuals who has really given a lot to the genre of jazz. And so we wanted to incorporate him in there, the music in there. But what you can do with your family is you can go on to Netflix, you can watch the Miles Davis documentary, you can go on to you know, the internet and do a lot of research on Miles Davis and how he has contributed to music to this day. Like once you learn more about him, you can learn about how he has really shaped music in America, period, for all people. And so some of that inspiration for the music also came from a different part of the book where it brings up his eye is on the sparrow and how the great grandma loves that song. And so that's a really beautiful gospel song. It's also embedded in this video. And so what you can do is you can study more about different gospel songs, or you could even talk to your family, like have everybody in the household share some of the songs in their families, you know, that have a lot of connection to like their spirituality or a lot of connection to their family history. Like I know in my case, my father passed away about 14 years ago. And so there are songs that are really important to him that I can bring to my children. Actually, my children really know those songs. But, you know, those are different things that you can do to really connect to music. And, you know, those of you that know a lot more about music than I do, you can have even better ideas. But another thing that you can do is you can do a whole lesson on art. And, you know, Daniel Minter did a beautiful job with his artistry. He's even has like symbols like this heart shape, which we know is a symbol that came from Africa and was really brought to our mainstream modern culture. You know, the symbol of the heart, but we know that it has roots in Africa. And so it's really beautiful how he honors that symbol in many of the pages. So you can do an art lesson where you can depict your own family stories, or you can even expand on the stories within the book and have your children create beautiful art. Something that I love that I got through like the work of August Wilson with Center Theater Group is learning about Romare Bearden, who is an amazing African-American artist that inspired August Wilson with his plays and his creations. So you can go onto a website that has Romare Bearden work, and you can do lots of studies about beautiful things in African-American culture that are depicted through Romare Bearden. So that's something else that you can do. Something that I know that I do often with my own kids and also with my students is you can do community circles with some of the themes in here. You know, bring everybody in your household that is in quarantine with you, or you know, that lives in your household, and you can ask questions like, what are our family reunions like? And so I know some of us might have family reunions that are part of our traditions already. I know that in my Carrasco side of my family, we used to have those before, you know, unfortunately my tías and tíos started passing away. We used to have those every few years. And so I have some really good memories of, as you know, being a kid, going on family reunions that are very similar to the ones that they do annually here in this book. If you don't do those, you know, like when have your family members been together? And the sad thing is oftentimes, you know, we talk about how, you know, it takes a death in the family or some type of tragedy to bring us together. And so that's something that right now you can talk about with your children. You can talk about being intentional, trying to come together, not just for tragedies, and how maybe starting traditions like that, like the one in this book, are something that you can aspire to do. I know that now that a lot of my aunts and uncles have passed on, my dad is gone, thank God my mom is still alive, but one of the things that we've done in our family, you know, me being the oldest sibling, is, you know, we get together, we bring all our kids together, and we try to, you know, every so often, you know, barbecue, have our carne asadas, or we don't all eat meat, so our garden burgers or whatever it is that we decide to you know, cook together and enjoy one another, tell stories, be very intentional about how much we love each other. And so that's something that for me really connects to a lot of the themes in the story as well. But you can also ask like what are our family traditions? Like, you know, maybe it's not the family reunion, but what is it that you do that is very similar? So you can kind of talk about that. Another thing that's really important that for me, you know, comes out in this book that you can do with your children is you can talk about just story writing in general. You could talk about counter narrative. You know, this is a beautiful book, but unfortunately, there are not enough books like this written by people of color. Okay, you're more likely to have a children's book that has the main character be a horse, a tractor, some type of, you know, like a truck, an animal, than you are to find characters that are, you know, children of color, African American, Native American, Asian American, or Chicano, Latino, and that's really sad. So you can kind of talk with your family about that, about counter narratives, about taking back the narrative about our communities and showing, you know, how beautiful we are and the beautiful things that we do, and really capturing that. And also with that, you could even go as far as creating your own books at home, similar to going down home with daddy. You know, it's really, really difficult and it's very rigorous to write a children's book. This is a lot of work. This takes a lot of critical thinking. This takes a lot of intention. Right now that you have the time, you can actually have your children create books like this with illustrations that share these beautiful stories. you know, that would be something that would be really great that could come from this quarantine, is maybe we'll have a whole lot of books about Filipino American families, about, you know, Mexican American families, about our families and the beautiful things that we do, and, you know, and get them published and share them with one another. Wouldn't that be great? So those are just some of the ideas that I have, and what I'm gonna do is, in the comments section, I'm gonna put a link to the guiding principles of ethnic studies that are part of the liberated ethnic studies model curriculum. I'm also gonna put a link to some of the books that I use, but I think what I'm gonna do is I'm going to continue to read more of these books with you and bring them to you.